But I didn't set out to work as a prosecutor to begin with. I kind of somewhat stumbled into it. I'd worked in accounting and finance in industry for about 17 years before coming to the prosecutor's office. And in 2002, frankly, I was looking for a job, and a friend told me that the Summit County prosecutor was looking for an attorney in her tax division. Given my background in finance and accounting, this seemed like a good fit. Basically, I figured I'd do the job for a few years and move on. But now it's been nearly 20 years later, and I'm still in the office. But I don't do any tax, or don't do much tax-related work anymore. But I'm doing other things that I do find to be very interesting and really challenging at times. The best part of it is the variety. We do so many different things in the civil division. We do everything from fairly simple giving advice to various offices to representing the county in civil rights cases where, frankly, it's typically the county that's being sued. And I'm always having to learn new things because you really have to be a jack of all trades in this position. We have 8 attorneys in the civil division, and we're always addressing things that we've never addressed before. So that's a very interesting piece of this, is learning new things, and not only that, but having to keep up with current events and things like that. The worst thing is that is a part of being the best thing is that you're always having to learn new things, and that can be challenging because you do, as I said, you have to be a jack of all trades, and sometimes the research can be daunting because we get oddball questions quite often that you really have to scratch your head and try to figure out where to even start to do the research, and that can be tough. And plus, you get questions from whether it's another county office or the townships, where people really want to do something. They're basically coming to you and asking, how can I do X, Y, or Z? And sometimes you have to tell them, well, you can't do X, Y, or Z. You just don't have the authority for it. That's a very typical thing that happens, is that people want the authority to say make some improvements in their community, and the law just doesn't always give them that authority. I advised the sheriff's office about the issuance of concealed carry licenses, and this is an area where there's a significant interest in these. Obviously, if you look at the statistics, quite a few people in our community have concealed carry licenses, but there are factors that can disqualify people from holding that license and carrying a firearm. So that's one instance where it can be quite a gray area. You get people that have old convictions or out-of-state convictions. We've even seen instances where we get military records where maybe someone had a less than stellar performance in the military, and you have to try to sort out whether what happened with them was actually disqualifying or not. Especially some of the things in the military, it's not always clear from the records we receive whether a person was actually convicted of a crime versus having an administrative action done against them, and they were then asked to leave the military. So you want to be fair to all applicants, but also you don't want people to receive licenses that are prohibited under the law. So that can be an interesting area where you really have to dig into the facts and sometimes make a bit of a judgment call as to, you know, whether someone is disqualified or not. I think probably one of the biggest misconceptions is how involved the prosecutor's office is with many of the issues that come up that are seemingly political disputes or political issues. Oftentimes when elected officials will say take a position on an issue in their community, quite often they'll come to us first to at least get a legal perspective on it, such as I had mentioned, whether they even have authority to do a certain thing. You know, they'll come to us first and say, do I have the authority to do this? And then, you know, if we do say, well, yeah, you have the authority, but there still may be concerns about how you go about doing it. And certainly the people that are taking those actions, they want to understand, even if we say they have authority to do something, what the legal ramifications could still be if they, say, do it wrong, if they don't take all the actions they need to take in order to implement whatever it is that they're thinking about. We get those questions quite often, and we can frankly seemingly be in the middle of these controversies, which frankly we are. We can tend to get in the middle of these things because if it does generate litigation later on, we are going to be the ones that defend the county or the elected official that took the action.